you have to get a lot of voters, some of whom are fairly socially conservative, that you don't associate with the most left progressive policies necessarily.
The majority of Democrats who helped flip the House in 2018 were moderates. James Carville made the argument over the weekend that we've got to get practical.
The first and most important plank in my climate proposal is beat Trump.
Does practical mean that the 89 or so million people who are uninsured or underinsured in this country continue to suffer? Does being practical mean that we don't take steps in this country to deal with climate chaos and bring world leaders to bear? Does being practical mean that we continue to prop up a legal system that is unjust in every stretch of the imagination, that bears its weight down on black men and black women, and then by extension, if you are Hispanic or indigenous or poor? Does being practical mean that we don't say to the American people that you deserve better than what you are getting? That's not the kind of practicality we want. Does practical mean that you hold fundraisers and wine caves with Swarovski crystals with billionaires who want to control this system? Does practical mean we continue to go with the status quo while 500,000 people sleep on the streets at night? That's not practicality. What the American people in this country need, they need somebody that is unabashed and that has the courage and the conviction to stand up for them and to call out the rigging of this system.
Because if you are not mad as hell about a system that suffocates the life out of everyday people, if you are not mad as hell that some folks in this country go to sleep at night with no food, no gas, no light, no clean water, if you are not mad as hell about injustice, then something is wrong with you.
Steps and a revolution are two different things. In order to get to a revolution, you've got to take steps.
The elites in 1930 said the same thing about FDR. And he said, I welcome your hatred. These are the same people that if the Reverend Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. was still alive, when he stood up before he was gunned down and he said to this country, he said the evils of this country, militarism, materialism, poverty, and racism. Those are those same people. So now if President FDR had listened to those people, or if the Reverend Dr. Martin Luther King had listened to those people, we would not progress as a nation. So every generation, we got the naysayers, baby. But what the folks of this country need, they need somebody that's gonna stand up for them. What people need is to be able to call upon somebody that's not going to capitulate. Elections have consequences. So if we want better folks elected, if we want better public policies, then we need to elect different people to office. We need more folks who use their strength to pull up, because we are our sisters and our brothers' keepers. You see, I've never met anybody who said that when I grow up, I want to be poor. And I want to be on public assistance, and I want to be on Medicaid, and oh my God, public housing is the life for me. But I do know people who sometimes fall short, because you know what? We all don't run the race at the same pace. Hope is the motivator, but the dream is the driver. The reason why we do what we do every single day, the reason why we continue to fight, is because we hope and believe that tomorrow will be better than today. The challenges of our time are similar to the challenges of the past, but we can surmount those challenges if we put a little extra on our ordinary, if we do what Eleanor Roosevelt once said, which is we must do the very thing that we think we cannot do. We must continue to stand and to fight, and that is the key. Because you deserve better, your children deserve better, and future generations of this great nation deserve better than what we are getting. We have the power. We, us, together, can continue to surmount the challenges of our day. I stand for the Mother Joneses of the world. I stand. I stand for our children. I stand for our communities. I stand for steel workers. I stand for carpenters. The power, though, is in our hands. And I don't want you to get weary in well-doing, because we are the answer that we have been looking for.